was brought down in part by his own words.
The government recordings of the then governor were often the main attraction during trial. Investigative reporter Ben Bradley is here with that part of the story. Ben.
Micah and Joe, at his sentencing in 2011, Rod Blagojevich said his own personal flaws and insecurities were on display in phone calls that he would later learn were being recorded by the FBI. Those calls would eventually lead in part to his conviction.
The FBI's undercover recordings of Rod Blagojevich while he was governor provided the underpinnings of the case against him. Blagojevich was heard, in his own words, scheming to sell Barack Obama's Senate seat. It wasn't a purely cash transaction, but one in which the governor hoped to secure the best deal for himself, as opposed to the person who could best represent the people of Illinois.
I've got this thing, and it's golden. And I'm just not giving it up for nothing.
That moment may have perfectly crystallized the governor's greed, but there were other recordings in which Blagojevich could be heard providing his frank assessment of the people who wanted to be appointed to the Senate.
I mean, Jesse Jr., it's a repugnant thought to me. I can't believe anything he says. What he's got third parties saying to me is a heck of a lot more substantial than what we're getting from the Obama people, okay?
I understand.
But, you know, I don't believe him. I don't trust him. I used to like him. I don't like him anymore. He's a bad guy.
The FBI recordings also revealed Blagojevich's frustration with his dismal approval ratings.
I busted my and I gave your grandmother a free ride on a bus, okay? I gave your baby a chance to have health care. And what do I get for that? Only 13% of y'all out there think I'm doing a good job. So f*** all of you.
Blagojevich would later refer to his own conduct as childish, immature, ugly, and petty. He told the judge at sentencing, quote, "If this case was about someone charging me with being self-absorbed, I would have cooperated and pled guilty immediately." Of course, a jury convicted him not just for his words, but his actions as well.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what he says when he comes out, because he's really shown no contrition up to this point. I wonder, now that his appeals have all been exhausted and he's gotten this move from the president now, might he be a little bit more open and sorry?
No, I don't think so. He's gotten less contrite over the years, more combative, more insistent upon his innocence. And I reread his statement that he made at sentencing to the judge. He really struggled to take responsibility for his actions in that statement. I think we're going to see a fiery Blagojevich. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see him on the media a lot, perhaps selling a book, but he's got to make some money too for his family.
And he never thought he did anything wrong, ever. So, all right, thanks, Ben.
Thanks, Ben.
We'll continue to follow this breaking story on the WGN News at 6. You can also get a wrap up of the day's events on the WGN News at 9 and 10. Look for